Ceramics. Their production is one of Europe's oldest industries. Today, the sector is a giant, worth over 30 billion euros each year and supporting almost 340,000 jobs. One of the key players is Keope Ceramics, based in Casalgrande, northern Italy. Founded as part of the Gruppo Concorde, a second-generation, family-run business, Keope's tiles are exported to more than 80 countries worldwide. But this success comes at a price. Ceramics are incredibly energy and water intensive. Making just one ton of tiles demands about 1,700 kilowatt hours of energy. That's what an average European household consumes in 6 months. And it requires around 15 liters of fresh water per square meter of tile.
This demand of energy cannot be met easily, especially because our process is a continuous process that works 24/7.
After 20 years at the company, technical manager Marco Manfredini has seen firsthand the struggles caused by rising costs and shifting markets.
The only thing we can do, being based in Italy, is to try to increase efficiency, reduce the amount of energy that we have to use, and look for any possible means to recover any energy that is lost, that would otherwise be lost.
Keope had already established various solutions to recover energy, but the company went one step further, installing a prototype heat pipe condensing economiser, or HPCE. This special heat exchange technology was developed as part of the European iWAYS project. It recovers water as well as heat. Luca Montorse is coordinating the project, which is supported by 20 partner institutes across Europe. The core technology was invented by Professor Hussam Juhara.
We basically were wondering, can we get rid of this white smoke that is coming out of exhaust stacks? And we realized that there is still a tremendous amount of energy available to recover in the form of vapors that are escaping through the stack.
Here is the idea. In exhaust streams, which are generated during the manufacturing process, valuable water vapor carries much of the wasted energy. When the vapor cools, it condenses and releases heat. The task of the HPCE is to capture this exact moment. The HPCE uses an array of sealed heat pipes to quickly and passively transfer heat from the hot exhaust stream to a cooler fluid flowing across the top. As the exhaust cools, condensate runs down the pipes and is collected.
Now we are recovering around 792 kilowatts. Today, the maximum energy recovered was around 850 kilowatts. The system is dynamic. It reacts to what's coming to it. So if the exhaust flow goes up and the temperature goes up, we don't have to do anything. The system will self-adjust and it will just deliver the heat in a useful form that goes as hot water to the factory.
But the wastewater that the HPCE system recovers can't go straight back into production. That's why the project is also developing water treatment solutions tailored to production processes. Maria Grazia Asci is part of the company responsible for treating the recovered water in such harsh industrial environments.
The challenge is related to the characteristics of the stream to be treated because this stream is characterized by high value of COD and also there are traces of oil and hydrocarbons.
Such substances can seriously damage equipment. That's why the team installed a two-step filtration system. Ultrafiltration uses membranes to capture larger pollutants such as clay and glaze, and nanofiltration targets smaller contaminants like salt and organic molecules, ensuring the water is clean for use in production. Each year, Keope produces more than 5 million square meters of tiles. With production on this scale, it is estimated that the HPCE can recover around 6 gigawatt hours of heat each year and reduce freshwater use by more than 400,000 litres.
The whole system proved to be very stable, very easy to operate, and we were very satisfied. As we speak now, the system is recovering energy that is equivalent to more or less 60 standard cubic meters of natural gas.
We created an industrial prototype, but in the future it can be an industrial component, a technology that an industry can decide to buy because it brings value.
Across Europe, industries share the same challenge: how to produce more with fewer resources. In ceramics, the answer is taking shape: reclaiming waste heat, reusing water, and drastically cutting emissions. A transition essential for sustaining both industry and the environment.